Dear students, welcome to the online lecture series of environmental science. Dear viewers, we are discussing about the water pollution, and in the previous lecture we saw the causes of water pollution, what are the sources which results detrimental effects on the quality of water or harmfully affects the quality of water. Once the water gets polluted, it shows many detrimental or deteriorating effects on many sectors, be it on the water body itself and human beings, and if the water is used for different purposes like industries, like agricultural activities and so many other activities. Where the polluted water actually gets used, it shows a negative impacts or negative results or detrimental impacts on each and every sector where the polluted water is actually utilized. So what are the effects, what are the detrimental results of the polluted water? We will try to learn these in detail in one by one. So we'll discuss about water pollution. Sorry, effects of water pollution. As already told you, water pollution has a spectrum of effects on different sectors, but if we keenly observe, the effects are all almost interrelated in nature, because once the physical property of the water gets damaged or badly affected, it ultimately favors the detrimental effect on the biological properties of water and chemical properties of water. What may be the effects of water pollution on different sectors? Because the water pollution has a different has a broad spectrum of effects on different sectors, already told you. So we'll try to discuss these one by one in detail. Water pollution has many impacts on different sectors. The most important effect on the water quality is eutrophication. Then what actually eutrophication means? Eutrophication simply means excessive nutrient enrichment of any water body. For example, if we are having a water body here, this is a water body, and if the growth of algal bloom results, for example, algal bloom results. And the main cause of the algal bloom in the water body is because of addition of nutrients. And the nutrients may be nitrogen and phosphate. Means these are the two nutrients which generally we are using as fertilizers in our agriculture field. And after applying these fertilizers, NPK fertilizers, on dissolving, these make their way towards the nearest water bodies, and because these are nutrients in nature, both these are nutrients, so it increases the productivity of crops on the water body, and excessive nutrient enrichment of water body takes place, and this is this we call as eutrophication. We will discuss in detail later on. Then we have biomagnification. Bio and magnification, we have two different words here, magnify or magnification or biomagnification. Biomagnification simply means, we have already discussed about the food chain. For example, we have a phytoplankton here, for example, phyto, then we have zooplankton, plankton. Then we have small fish and large fish, for example. Then what does biomagnification mean? Biomagnification simply means bio plus magnify. Bio, you know, life. And where the life actually existing? Phytoplankton belong to life. Zooplankton, small fish, large fish, all these are biological organisms or the biological entity. And magnification simply means magnify, to increase. So biomagnification or biological magnification simply means increase in concentration of any chemical, the chemicals especially the non-biodegradable in nature. For example, DDT is there. If the water body is receiving non-biodegradable substance, then some of the portion of the non-biodegradable substance or the chemicals of the or the heavy metals may get accumulate here, and it passes the same heavy metal or the chemical, especially the non-biodegradable, to the zooplankton, and successively goes on increasing in a food chain. And such mechanism of increasing in an amount of chemical through a particular food chain or through trophic level is simply known as biomagnification. Then we have deoxygenation or reduction of oxygen in our water bodies. As we all know, oxygen is one of the most important parameter which determines the quality of water significantly, because the amount of dissolved oxygen favors the growth of organism, and the organism may be nectin, and depending upon the amount of oxygen availability, so the growth of organism may be pathogens depending upon the amount of dissolved oxygen present in any particular water body. So what actually dissolved oxygen means? Amount of oxygen dissolved in a particular water body. How much amount of water? For example, we say 14 milligrams of oxygen per liter of water is a almost a pure water quality we can consider. So if we are adding organic substance, say for example we are adding agriculture wastes or any other biodegradable wastes in our water body, on reaching the water body it gets decomposed with the passage of time because of presence of so many decomposers are there. So decomposition simply uses amount of dissolved oxygen, which results reduction of dissolved oxygen in the water body. Before adding pollutant to any water body, say for example we are having 14 milligrams of oxygen per liter of water, but as we add amount of pollutant to the water bodies, and the dissolved oxygen gets used for decomposition, then the water body may show result 10 milligrams of oxygen per liter of water, means amount of oxygen gets reduced. Then we have increase in biological oxygen demand. Simply, if the oxygen gets reduced in a particular water body, then there are number of biota, say for example fish are there, say for example a small fish, large fish, or so many other organisms are there which uses oxygen for respiration, especially through the gills. Then from 14 milligram, now the oxygen availability is 10 milligram, but the demand of the oxygen is so much high because different organisms need oxygen, and every organism has a limiting factor in how much amount of oxygen availability is good for their survival. So amount of oxygen is reduced, which increases the demand of the oxygen, which we simply known as biological oxygen demand. increase in biological oxygen demand or increase in BOD simply means the water body is getting polluted. Similarly, the chemicals are there as we are reading from different source industries, factories or sewages or so many other causes are there. So chemicals also use oxygen available in the water body to decompose itself, and the chemicals also demand oxygen for their decomposition. So this means chemical oxygen demand, or we say COD. Then we have effect on aquatic food chain. We will try to explain in later lectures in details. Effect on the aquatic food chain. As we already mentioned here, for example, here is a food chain. For example, we have phytozoo, small and large fish are there, or fish eating birds maybe. If the water body gets polluted and any organism, say for example, we have negative effect of water pollution on the zooplanktons and no effect on the large fish. But if the effect is not directly affecting the large fish, but affecting on these small fish or the zooplanktons, zooplankton is actually the feeding ground for the small fish, which results the decline of small fish. As a result, large fish gets devoid of food, unavailability of food results, which also results decline of this species or collapse of food chain, especially aquatic food chain. Then we have diseases. So many diseases. For example, we have water related disease. Say for example, we have typhoid. So for example, we have cholera. Say for example, we have dysentery. Dysentery. Actually, these are the effects which is caused due to addition of pollutants or due to growth of the pathogenic organisms like Salmonella typhi, Vibra cholerae or Shigella dysentery. For example, growth of organism is actually the result of the polluted water. And if the same water it gets consumed by any human being, then the such disease may result. Then we have loss or decline of aquatic species or aquatic birds. For example, if we are adding chemical substance, especially non-biodegradable substance, then this may result in the decline of aquatic birds. For example, as we already discussed about the biomagnification. So what happens, for example, if we are adding non-biodegradable substance to the water bodies, it may result weakening of eggshells. Weakening of eggshells. For example, it has to hatch out on the 10th very day, but as the water gets polluted because of addition of non-biodegradable substance, then such eggs gets hatched out or gets damaged because of the weakening of the shells on 8th day or 7th day or day before the actual hatching day, which results decline of the aquatic birds or the species. Then we have loss of water bodies. Actually, how water pollution results the loss of water body. For example, we have four different stages of water. For example, this is oligotrophic stage. Oligotrophic stage. Then we have mesotrophic stage of water. Then we have eutrophic stage. Then we have diastrophic. Means these are the four stages of water on the basis of which we can say the status or the quality of water on which standard the water body exists actually. Oligotrophic is the stage of water where there is no nutrient. Actually, you are supposed to keep in mind that addition of nutrients deteriorates or harmfully affects the quality of water, as already discussed, as already mentioned in the eutrophication. Oligotrophic means there is negligible or no presence of nutrients in the water bodies, and such water bodies are almost pure in nature. Then we have mesotrophic stage. The mesotrophic stage of any particular water body is characterized by the presence of nutrients in the form of nitrates, in the form of phosphates, or in the form of any other nutrients, which results the growth of phytoplanktons present in the water body, which results in algal bloom. Hence, mesotrophic is a later stage of the water body, which is a polluted one. Then, similarly, we have eutrophic stage. Eutrophic actually means you means true, truly nourished lakes. Eutrophic means truly nourished lakes. The water bodies has got tremendous amount of nutrients in the form of nitrates, phosphate, and so many other nutrients, which results the growth of phytoplanktons, and ultimately the quality of the water body gets reduced. We are supposed to discuss in detail. Then we have dystrophic stage. Dystrophic stage means almost the water body has got converted into a marshy areas. So these are some of the status of the water body on the basis of which we can determine, we can say the water body on which status the water body actually exists. But we should keep in mind that after the dystrophic stage of any particular water body, we can't restore the water body again into its original position. Up to eutrophic stage, we have number of methods. For example, we have dredging method is there, we have aeration is there. We have so many methods and devices are there through which we can restore the quality of water. But once the water body gets reached in the dystrophic stage, we can't restore back the quality of water again into an original quality of water. Hope you understand these. In next very lecture, we will try to explain you in detail what are the what actually biomagnification means, what actually deoxygenation means, what actually biomagnification means, and other topics I mentioned here. We will try to learn and discuss in detail in later on. Till then, stay home, stay safe, best of luck.